Hello children, today's video is about the poem Where Do All the Teachers Go? Here the poet is curious to know about the lifestyle of the teachers. He wants to know the teacher's life, what the teachers do after the school time. So what are his questions and what does he want to do to get his answers? We will see in this poem. For a little child, a teacher is special. Yes, of course, a teacher is special for a child, for the student. It is difficult for a small child to think of his or her teacher as an ordinary person. So a child cannot think that his teacher is an ordinary person. He is something or someone special. So what are those things that make the teachers special? So he wants to know. Now we'll go line-wise. Where do all the teachers go when it's 4 o'clock? Do they live in houses and do they wash their socks? See the first stanza, first line. The question is asked, where do all the teachers go? The child doesn't know where do the teachers go. So he wants to know, where do all the teachers go when it is 4 o'clock? Means after school time, where do the teachers go at 4 o'clock? Do they live in houses? He has a question. He is asking that, do they live in houses? The houses like we have, or the houses of the other people have. And do they wash their socks? So, do they wash their socks by themselves? Are they simple? Are they like us, that they do their own work? Do they wear pajamas? And do they watch TV? So again, he says that, do the teachers wear pajamas? Means like casual clothes at home, casual pants at home? And do they watch TV, or do my teachers also watch television like us? And do they pick their noses? Do they clean their noses like we clean? Do they pick their noses the same as you and me, like we all do? Do they pick their noses also? Pick their noses means here to clean the nose, or to just play with nose, or as a fun. Do they live with other people? Have they mums and dads? And were they ever children? And were they ever bad? Again, he had another question, that do the teachers live with other people? He is asking that, do the teachers live with other people in their house, in their houses? Have they mums and dads? Do my teachers, they have mums and dads, they have mothers and daddy, fathers? And were they ever children? And it is his question, so innocent question, that he is asking that his teachers were, once upon a time, were they children like him? Or, and were they ever bad? And did they do some bad things in their childhood? These are the questions in the kid's mind. Here again, did they ever never spell right? He says again, like the teachers also made mistakes, or they did some wrong spelling, though they wrote some wrong spellings when they were students. It is a question. Did they write wrong spellings when they were students? Did they ever make mistake? Did his teachers make mistake like he makes in his class? He has a question. He felt that teachers are special and they cannot do these normal things. That's why he is writing. He is thinking about these things. If they pinched the chocolate flakes, were they punished in the corner? If they pinched the chocolate flakes, here, were my teachers also punished in the corner? They were punished and they were make stand in the corner. For if they pinched a chocolate flakes, if they stole or if they played with the chocolate flakes of others. So, were my teachers punished? This is the question. See, here those things, the things which are given here, the child is thinking that his teacher is special and that's why he cannot live a simple like we all live. These other people are like here the teachers can wash socks and the teachers wear pajamas and the teacher watch TV. But here the student, the person, or the child, he thinks that the teachers cannot do these common things like other people. So he is just asking his questions. His teacher has these activities. Did they ever lose their hymns books? So He is again asking that, did my teachers, he lost his books, his hymns books, did they ever leave their greens? Did they ever leave their greens? And did they scribble on the desktops? So again he is asking that, did my teachers also do the same things, like scribbling on the top desktops and making or breaking the things in the classroom and the home? So he has such questions, so innocent questions, that his teachers, he is not in the mood to think that his teachers are like him. He feels that his teachers are different, and so that he is asking such questions to his mind, and he wants to know the answer. Why, what are then, if the teachers are not doing like them or like other people, then what the teacher does at home or after 4 o'clock, he wants to know. So did they wear old dirty jeans? So here is also again another question, that did my teacher wear old dirty jeans like we all wear? He cannot imagine that his teacher can wear dirty jeans. So here at last, after ask these few stanzas, whatever the questions are, what are his questions, that where do the teachers go at 4 o'clock? This is the question. So what at 4 o'clock or after school time, where did the teacher go? And do my teachers live in the houses? Do they wash their socks? Means do they act like we all do, or do they do same works or household works like us? Do they wear pajamas? Do they watch televisions? And they do activities like common people. Do they all think like this? Whatever these questions he had, he wanted to know. So what are those? So here, at last, in the last stanza, I will follow one back home today. So he decides here that I will follow one teacher after school, one teacher's up to his home. Today I'll follow one teacher. I will find out what they do. And here he says that he will find out what the teachers do after 4 o'clock, after the school time. He wants to find out what the teachers do. Then I will put it in a poem. So here at last he says that he is going to find out the activities, the routine of the teachers, and he is going to write down, pen down in a poem, in the form of poem, that they can read to you. And I will write down the poem about the teachers, and the same poem will be taught by the teachers in front of you, miss, here in front of the students here. So here the child has many questions in his mind, that simply, do they wear pajamas, and do they watch television, do they pick their noses like common people? Again he has some questions, that do my teacher has mom and dad, means he has mothers or mother and father. The teacher lives with other family members, and whether they had a childhood or not, whether my teacher was bad in his childhood days or not. So these are the questions which he wanted to know about the teacher. And at last he says that he would follow the teacher, and he would try to know what the teachers do after 4 o'clock and after the school time, and what they do. Whatever he will find out, he will write every incident, everything in the form of poetry, and the same poetry will be taught by the teachers, the same teachers, before the students. So here we'll discuss some questions also. First question, why does the poet want to know where the teachers go at 4 o'clock? See here, first question, we can say, why does the poet want to know? Here, because of curiosity, he wants to know only. He does not have any special reason. After knowing, he wants to know what the teachers do after 4 o'clock, and he wants to write down the poem. That's it. What are the things normal people do that the poet talks about? Here normal people do. Here poet talks about the normal things. That what are the normal people do? The normal people live in houses. The normal people wash their socks. The normal people wear pajamas. The normal people watch television. The normal people pick their noses. Okay. And the normal people have moms and dads. And the normal people sometimes act badly also. The normal people make mistakes, they are punished by the elders, okay? So they lose their things, they wear dirty clothes. These are the things which are done by the normal people. Here the poet talks about, what does he imagine about these? Where teachers live. Here, where teachers live. He imagines, the poet imagines that teachers doesn't live in a home or in a house. He may be living in a some supernatural thing or some other place. What they do at home, he may feel that the poet may feel that the teachers may not wash their socks or may not act like common people. The people with whom they live. So here, here he is imagining, he is thinking that whether my teachers live with their parents or with their moms and dads. Their activities when they were children in the school, he also feels that the teacher, his teachers will might have done the same activities like him. He's imagining. Why does the poet wonder if teachers also do things that other people do? The poet wonders here. Why he is wondering? He is wondering that the teacher, he according to him, the teachers are the special people. They are not like common, and that's why if he finds that the teacher also do the same thing, that those things will shock him or wonder him. How does the poet plan to find out? What will he do once he finds out? So here, what was the plan? In the last stanza, the poet plans to follow the teacher to find out what the teacher do. And once he finds out what the teachers do, he is going to write them in the form of poetry so that the teachers will read the same poetry, same poem before the students. What do you think these phrases from the poem mean? Here's this phrase, punished in the corner, means here, punished in the school, leave their greens. Okay, so here the poem comes to end. So I hope you all have understood this poem. So we'll have another lesson in the next video. Till then, bye bye.